21. Calculate the delta S notch for the following changes. Then we have copper solid yields copper gas. Okay, so I'm trying to find the delta S. So that just means that we're trying to find the change, right? That delta is always the change value and the change in entropy. So we're thinking of randomness of molecules going on in our container. Now keep in mind that if we're going from a solid to a gas, right? The solid molecules, and maybe I'll do this in a different color, the solid molecules are very, very tightly compacted, and the gas molecules are all over the place, right? So generally, we're going to something that is more random. So we already know that our delta S value, that standard delta S value, has to be a positive because I'm increasing in my randomness, increase in entropy. Now we just got to find the exact number. Well, anytime that you see that you have this notch, that means that we're using standard values, and I have to go into the back of the textbook to find out what those values are. So that's what I did for you guys. Now, how do we use those values to get an actual answer? Well, here comes the formula. It's this. Delta S for the whole reaction just equals the sum. That's this little squiggly, right? This is the sum. And that just means you just got to add them all up, right? So it's the sum of all the products minus the sum of all the reactants. So it's just products minus reactants for the delta S values. Now, do I have to change these values or can I keep them? Well, that goes by what the coefficients are. In front of the Cu solid and the Cu gas, there is only one of each in the balanced equation. So technically, you would take both values and times them by those coefficients. In this case, they're both ones. But if there was a two, you would have to times it by two, times it by three, whatever the coefficient is. So this would still be 33.15, and this would be 166.38. Now, we're just going to take the total values, right, and just plug them in. So the delta S for my whole reaction would be the product. There was only one of them, so 166.38. And I'm just going to subtract the 33.15. And now I'm going to get my answer. My delta S value for my whole entire reaction, as you can see, it's going to be a positive value. And we guess correctly, right? So we know we're on the right track. 166.38 minus 33.15. I get 133.23, and the units for a delta S value is always joules per mole times Kelvin, which is the same thing as this. It doesn't matter whether you slash it this way or slash it this way. It's the same thing. And that is your answer. Not bad. What'd you think? Okay, I'm done coloring. I really hope this helped. Let me know in the comments. Thank you so much for viewing the video. Subscribe to the channel, and I look forward to helping you in future questions. Bye-bye.